Now, remember, your goal here is to start with a series of hypotheses. That's all you have on day one. If you're a domain expert, maybe you know a little more, but it's okay because you're just kind of guessing here. You start with, well, here's who I think my customers are. But then you get out of the building and you start running experiments and you find out, oh, I was right. Or more often, on your first guess is, I was wrong. And because we're going to do these experiments cheaply, inexpensively, and upfront, we're going to save all the enormous waste we would do if we waited until we launched the product and did an expensive marketing campaign, and then only then realizing that, oops, these weren't our customers, or these were our customers, but we built the wrong features. So let's dive down a level deeper and first focus on what's the jobs needed to be done. That is, what's the customer segment trying to get done, and is it a problem or need? Now, this phrase, jobs to be done, was first popularized by Clayton Christensen, who wrote a series of books, The Innovator's Dilemma and The Innovator's Solution, should probably be on any entrepreneur's reading list. And what Christensen said is, look, what functional or social jobs are getting done? That is, does the customer want to perform or complete a specific task or solve a problem or trying to look good, gain power or status? Or are there some emotional jobs? Do they want to look better, feel good, feel more secure? And what basic needs are you helping your customer satisfy? Is it entertainment? Is it dating? Is it something hardwired into the human psyche?